pretty windy out here. 40, 50 mile an hour winds and snow. But we're still producing some power. The nice thing about the bifacial panels, even when it's cold and windy, it's clear on the back. Everything on the front is iced up. So let's see what the numbers are before my hands freeze. Solid.
The lengths I go through to bring you real world data. Welcome back to Projects with Everyday Dave. I have some very interesting winter performance results comparing conventional solar panels to bifacial panels. So let's dig into the numbers. I've done lots of bifacial testing up to this point, so I've included those results in my handy dandy chart for comparison. The first bar represents a conventional 390 watt panel, which might produce an average of 100 watts during the day. Over a 10 hour day, that would be about 1 kilowatt hour per panel. For the sake of comparison, we'll look at this from a percentage standpoint, assuming our conventional control panel produces 100% of what can be produced under a particular set of conditions. How much can we expect the bifacial panel to produce under the same conditions? From my analysis of bifacial panels mounted to a completely white roof, I showed a small benefit for that best case scenario of an 11% boost, putting us at 110% of the conventional panel output. Just a reminder, unless they're pitched on an angle on a completely white roof, bifacial's best application is a ground mount. From my thorough analysis of bifacial panel performance on a regular ground mount array, I showed a 13% boost for the lower panel and a 17% boost for the upper row panel, for an average output of 115% of the base panel. For that video, I also ran some experiments with the panels upside down with the face blocked to find the theoretical maximum output, which turned out to be 150% of a conventional panel. If it were somehow possible to achieve that, the output would be 1.5 kilowatt hours for that typical day. Now let's see how the winter results fit. Even though we were having a bit of a blizzard in the footage you saw at the beginning of the video, the entire array was still producing power. The ice diffuses the light, but it still allows a significant portion to get through. Even though the panels were covered in ice and there was no direct sunlight, I was still producing over 2,000 watts in the middle of the storm at the time that footage was taken. The bifacial panels had a distinct advantage in this situation since the backside was completely clear. The lower panel was producing 18% more than the conventional panels, and the upper panel was producing 24% more. So on average, I was producing 121% of the power of a conventional panel. The next day, we had a mostly cloudy day, and the panels melted all the ice. I got very similar results, plus 18% for the lower panel and plus 23% for the upper panel. That gives us an average output of 121% for low light conditions benefiting from the reflection of surrounding snow. Great, I'm happy with that. Seeing how good the cloudy performance was, I was really looking forward to a bright, sunny day to get my sunny snow day performance. The next day, December 25th, turned out to be exactly what I needed. Oh, before I go over that result, I don't want to forget to remind you about a significant change to the solar rules in California. If you live in California, you don't have a lot of time. There's a narrow window to get grandfathered in before the new rule takes effect. This change will dramatically impact the profitability of your solar install. Energy Sage has several helpful articles on this topic, and I've linked to them in the description below. Energy Sage is the tool that I used to get quotes for my solar install when I first started investigating solar. Unfortunately, there are some bad actors out there preying on people looking to install solar, and this is a good way to avoid getting scammed. You will get multiple quotes from pre-screened installers. If you want even more support, EnergyPal is another great free resource that will work with you to understand your specific needs and find the right supplier for you. Plus, they're still offering my viewers a $500 rebate if you end up using them for your installation. Both of these are free resources, so there's no risk to try it out. All the links you need are in the description below. Okay, back to the sunny, snowy day results. December 25th, the day after the cloudy day results, turned out to be exactly what I needed. I had to disconnect the whole center section of panels to keep the inverter from clipping because the array was producing so much power. That allows me to maintain good data for the remaining panels. To my disappointment, however, the delta between the conventional panels and the bifacial panels was much less than expected. The lower panel was only 7% better, and the upper panel only 11% better, averaging out to a measly 109% of a conventional panel. Now, obviously, the sunny day as a whole produced way more energy than the cloudy day. This chart is just showing relative performance between a conventional panel and a bifacial panel. So I must not be getting the big backside boost from the reflected snow that I expected. After some thought, I think the reason might be twofold. First, the best reflecting area behind the panels is shaded by the panels, meaning the backside boost on the ground array is mostly a result of ambient light, not the reflected light directly off the ground. Second, the ground in front of the array was also covered in snow, bouncing direct reflected sunlight across the entire front side of the array, boosting the output for all of the panels. So the bifacial panels were doing very well. It's just that the conventional panels were also doing better than normal, resulting in less delta between them. Unfortunately, that was the only snowy and sunny day that I had this winter, so I couldn't run the test again to confirm the results. Yeah, maybe next year. Either way, there's more to consider for winter performance. I just wanted to jump out here. There's a little bit of a break in the snow. We haven't had any sun yet today. It snowed several inches, and you can see right away the bifacial panels are going to be performing better than all the other panels. One, the backside is always available, so the light will reflect off the snow and will be able to pick up power from the backside. Then, because they get more light, they warm up faster, and you can see the front is shedding much faster than all the rest of the panels. These bifacial panels have all kinds of advantages, especially when you need power the most, when there's very little light available. They shed snow faster, they pick up light from the backside, they get more reflection from the surroundings. The low light performance is way better than a standard panel. The next day, the sun is trying to come out, and you can see the snow still hasn't completely cleared from the conventional panels. There are several things to notice from this snapshot in time. The upper string is the top row and the left two panels at the bottom row. There is enough power to turn that string on for the inverter. The bottom string, however, doesn't even have enough power to start up that string, and that's why the lower right bifacial is actually showing zero output. That string just isn't even on. You will also notice that the whole center section of the top row is producing zero power, even though only the bottom edge is covered in snow. Now, if I had half-cut solar panels, I would be getting at least 50% of the power from these panels. Half-cut panels like these bifacials split the panel into a top and bottom section, and that allows you to get performance out of one half if the other half is blocked. So that's a good illustration of one of the advantages of half-cut cells. You can also see the bifacial panel is producing about 22% more power than its cleared counterparts. If they were all bifacial panels, the array would be clear, and instead of producing 556 watts, it would be producing 1,959 watts. That's 2.5 times the output. The biggest advantage of bifacial panels isn't the 15% boost you get on a bright sunny day. You're probably going to be clipping that power anyway. It's the dramatic advantage you get on cloudy and snowy days when you need the power the most. Now, to be clear, this works best with a ground mount. For that same snowfall, you can see my shed, which has the backside blocked from light by the roof, did not see an advantage from the bifacials for shedding the snow like the main array did.
If I were doing a ground array today, I would definitely be using bifacial panels.
Well, the snow didn't provide the miracle performance that I was hoping for with that bright white reflection. Maybe I'll have to try some of the suggestions from the comments, like putting a lake behind the panels, installing white rocks or painting the rocks I have white, putting a white fence behind them, using a Mylar sheet or a white tarp or mirrors, or maybe even putting mirrors on an articulating rig that points the sunlight to the back of the panel wherever it's moving. No shortage of ideas from the comments section, so keep them coming. I really appreciate the support. If you want to see my summer results and roof mount results, I'll post them here for your reference. Only 5% of the people who watch my channel actually subscribe, and I have lots of future content that is going to be really interesting. So What's stopping you? Click the little circle and join the club. I have lots of useful content on my website, projectswithdave.com, that I have organized to try and make it easier for you to find useful information. So be sure and check it out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.